हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड टुडे अबाउट द फ्लोटिंग एंड सिंकिंग ऑफ सर्टेन ऑब्जेक्ट्स अराउंड अस। सो वी आर स्टडिंग द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ फ्लोटिंग एंड सिंकिंग और डेंसिटी ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट्स दैट वेदर दे फ्लोट और सिंक इन वाटर। सो फॉर दैट मैम हैज़ कलेक्टेड सो मैनी मटीरियल्स विथ हर। यू कैन सी वन बाई वन, देर इज़ अ स्पॉन्ज, देन दीज आर सम ड्राइड लीव्स, दिस इज कॉटन, then this you can see, this is matchstick, burnt matchstick, then here there are some items which are, you can see coins, then ma'am is having some marbles, some pebble, then this you can see screw is there, iron screw is there, then some cap, from the cap ma'am has got this, this is of metal, cap of pen. Then there are some other materials also, like you see here, this is the aluminium foil. Then these are some materials which are taken from your kit, like this is your pencil sharpener, then there is an eraser, there is a small piece of pencil, this is crayon color, then this is the cap of your sketch pen, then this is your birthday plastic card that you keep on your birthday cake. So these are some materials which are of daily use, students, for you. Generally you use these materials in your daily life. So ma'am has collected all these materials to show you that how we can understand the concept of floating and sinking, and this is done in water. Now students, first you should know what is density. Now density is mass per unit volume. So by this experiment it will become clear to you that which object out of these is having more density than water and which out of these is having less density than water. Actually objects, they float on water or sink in water based on the property of buoyancy. Means the upward force which is applied on the object by water, it is the buoyant force, and this principle of buoyancy was given by a great person in Greece, great scientist of Greece, and he is called as Archimedes. So you can understand this concept by seeing the various materials. Now first ma'am will try to put some materials, like you see here, this is your cotton. Cotton, if I put first, cotton will float as you are seeing. Okay, now this is sponge, small piece of sponge. Sponge, if I put in water, it is also floating. So its density is less than water, that's why these things are floating. Same way I have got a leaf, dry leaf. Dry leaf I am putting in water, you see dry leaf is floating. Now this is your matchstick. Now matchstick, you see it is put on water. When I put this in water, it is also floating. So all these materials are basically floating, but you can see slowly slowly this cotton, it is going down. Cotton is actually absorbing water and it is going down. Okay, so I will keep these things aside. Now let us take these materials. Okay students, these materials in which I have got the pebble, this red colored pebble, I'll put it in water. See what happened with that pebble, it has gone down, it has sunk in water. Now I've taken a marble. This is a marble I have put in water and it has also sunk in water. Means it has gone down and settled at the bottom surface. I have got this cap, some part of the cap is there, broken part, and it is also sunk in water. Now I have taken one nail. See, this is an iron nail. Iron nail put in water, it has also sunk in water. And this is one Coin is there with ma'am, and let's check with the coin. Coin, you see, coin has also sunk in water. So all these materials, that is your pebble, your coin, marble, metal cap part, and this iron nail, all this have sunk in water. And this also we will go on observing. You see, all the other materials are floating, but the cotton has sunk in water because cotton has absorbed water. So it has sunk in water because its density has increased as it has absorbed water. Now let us come with these daily use materials which you are having in your kit. There is a pencil. Let me try with pencil. Pencil, if I put on water, you see it's floating on water. This is your sharpener. Sharpener, if I put in water, let us check. The sharpener has sunk in water. Now let me see with this birthday card. Birthday plastic card that you use on your cake. We put it in water. See, it's floating on water. So its density is less than water. That's why it's floating on water. Now let me check with crayon. Crayon I am having. You can put it in water and see. It's also somewhat floating on water. Now let's check with your eraser. What happens with the eraser? Eraser also, you can see, it has sunk in water. The cap of your sketch pen, it is actually sink there, and you can see it has also, when it is put in water, it is also floating. Now I am having here your aluminium foil that is generally present in your tiffin boxes, and in this one piece I am putting on water, and you can check, you see it is floating on water. But if I do, let me do one more experiment in this. I have made a small ball out of this, a very small ball. Now let me see what happens with this. It is also put in water and it is also floating, you can see. So I have shown you here number of material, students, like these all, aluminium foil, your leaf, dry leaf, then sponge, then there is matchstick. These are all floating in water. Cotton was floating, but after absorbing water, it has sunk in water. Now here you can see you have got this pencil, sketch pen cap, then crayon, then plastic. These are all floating, while other materials, which you can see, I think from here clearly, there are other materials here at the bottom. That is your sharpener is there, then coin is there, then marble is there, then all this you can see here. Nails are there, iron nails. Then your eraser is there. All these have density more than water. So they have all sunk in water. So I hope by this experiment it is clear to you that some materials, they float on water, while some materials, they sink in water. Okay, students? So floating and sinking concept, I hope it's clear to all of you. So all of you can do this experiment very, very easily at home. You may be having most of these materials at home. So collect those all materials. Take water in a container. No need to take it in a glass container, because glass, it can be harmful if it breaks. It falls down and breaks. You can take help of your elders, and you can do this activity easily. Taking water in a container, collecting all the materials which are there around in your house, small small materials, and you can easily try out this activity. So this activity shows that many materials are there which have got density more than water, and they will sink in water, while there are some materials which have got density less than water, so they float on the surface of water. So I hope this activity of floating and sinking is clear to you, and they explain you it, this activity explains you clearly that how we can check that which material has density more than water and which material is having density less than water. and this activity can be done easily at your home. So thank you, children.